welcome to the next video in my series where I'm building a drum studio in my back garden. In this video we're going to go step by step through the process I took to build the foundation or the concrete base for the building. So let's get started. Now I started off by digging a hole about 35 centimeters deep and then I filled it with 10 centimeters of compacted hard core, 2.5 centimeters of sand, then a damp-proof membrane, followed by 75mm thick insulation. I added A142 mesh, otherwise known as concrete rebar, followed by some ready-mix C25 cement. And you can see here approximately the thicknesses of each layer and the overall cross-section of what the base looks like. Okay, so that's the theory. Now let's get into it. Now initially I didn't take too many videos of me digging out the foundation, apart from a video I captured of my friend here walking down the road. So here's a few pictures, step by step, of how I'm digging out the foundation. Now that the hole is dug, the first step of the process is to build a frame, otherwise known as shuttering or formwork. This is going to sit inside of the hole and form a nice structure for us to pour the concrete into. Once the concrete is cured, we'll then remove the frame. So after doing a test fit of the frame, I realised I needed to chip away at the edges a little bit more to give myself some more room just to get the frame in and give it a nice snug fit. Now you can see the frame is in, everything's level, and I'm starting to now backfill with some hardcore, otherwise known as MOT Type 1. Now that all the MOT is on site, I'm levelling it out and getting it as flat as I can to form a nice flat and level base for the subsequent layers. Unfortunately, because of the coronavirus pandemic, the building merchants and hire centres were closed at this time, so I was unable to get hold of a whacker plate or petrol compactor So for the time being, I just had to make do with using an old sleeper and a sledgehammer to get everything compacted down nice and tightly. You can see in the video actually how effective that has still been, so this should be more than good enough for this base. Now it is really important you do follow this step and you use the proper materials, not just a load of old bricks, because you've seen in the video how much the actual material has compacted down and gone all nice and flat and level, and that's what you need when you're putting on a concrete base. If you're left with lots of air gaps, then you're going to get movement and then you'll start to get some small subsidence or at least cracking in the floor. The next thing I'm doing here is adding in a layer of sand, which is approximately 2 to 2.5 centimeters thick. This is going to give us a nice layer of protection for the damp-proof membrane, which is going to go on next. This is really important as well, because if you've got any sharp edges that protrude through in the compacted floor underneath, that risks puncturing your damp-proof membrane and of course making any damp-proof characteristics of the membrane void. So it's really important just to make sure you've got a nice, smooth, soft sand base just to put the next layer onto. Now, one of the reasons I'm using a concrete base for my build is to maximise the available ceiling height due to the height restrictions on the overall building set under permitted works. So by having a concrete floor, I can get the floor level of the building as close to ground level as I need. And so now what I'm doing here is just fitting some quinfirm 75mm thick insulation underneath this concrete base so that it's nice and insulated and I do not lose any height in the ceiling having to do this on top of the base. In fact, this is a common technique used in construction of most nuclear homes these days. I'm now sealing all of the joints in the insulation with some aluminium foil tape. You can see here that the insulation has a foil backing, so combined with the tape it will create a vapor barrier. More on this in a later video. It will also help stop any concrete from forming between the gaps of the insulation. The next job is for me to insert some plastic ducting, which will allow me to pull electrical cables through into the building, through the concrete base, and then up through the stud work, rather than me having to drill a hole in the side of the building retrospectively. I've used some 20mm plastic piping for this, and I'm using two sets, one for the electric cables and another set for some Ethernet cables. I'm now cutting the reinforcement mesh down to size. The mesh I'm using is A142, it comes in 3.6 by 2 meter lengths. Each aperture is 200 millimeters wide or each square, and the thickness of the metal is 6 millimeters. This is more than adequate for this size of base. I've now laid it down here on some broken bricks to raise it up about 6 to 8 centimeters from the bottom of the base. For the maximum strength, it wants to sit about a third up from the bottom. I'm then using some wire ties to join the two cuts together and to fix the cable ducting in place. You'll notice there's a gap around the outside. You want to make sure there's about at least 10 centimeters from the edge. And now we're ready to start pouring the concrete. So I'm using a C25 grade ready mix concrete, which I've had delivered to site. The mixer is at the front and we're just wheelbarrowing now to the back of the property. In the end, I used about 1.5 cubic meters of concrete. And the final step is then just to level it off using a very straight piece of wood just to get a nice flat finish on the top. I'm going to fix some anchor bolts all around the outside so that I can bolt the timber frame down to the concrete base. I've pre-measured this all out. You saw this in the previous video, so I know exactly where bolts need to go so that they don't clash with the upright studs. I created a template out of some wood so that I knew that the bolts were exactly the right distance in from the outside of the frame so that they'd be perfectly aligned for the stud work. But lastly, I wasn't going to do this, but having been up and close with the concrete, I wanted to make sure it was all nice and level so that there was no rocking of the timber frame. And of course, once you start, you can't stop, so I just finished off smoothing out the whole base using a trowel. It's still a rustic finish, but it's more than adequate for this purpose. And here is the final product. So 1 week after the concrete was poured, I've removed all of the shuttering, and we're now ready for the next phase, which is to build and fix the walls. If you've enjoyed this video, then please like and share. If you're interested in following the build progress, then please subscribe to make sure you don't miss the next video, which will be on the wall construction. I've added links to the description of all the materials that I've used. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to post. And until the next video, take care.